Yeah, hi guys, Peter back for yet another video. I'm going to do an album ranking video today, but it's sort of like an era of the band, so it doesn't take in the whole discography. I'm going to do Van Halen, just the David Lee Roth period, from 78 to 84, the initial first Classic Six albums. I'm going to do that just today. I like the Sammy Hagar period. I find as time has gone on, I've really gone away from that sort of material. I just like a song here and there. For me, it's where it's about is the first six with Diamond Dave. And as I said, I initially was played a lot the Sammy Hagar stuff, but not so much these days. But a different kind of truth. I'm not including that. I'm just including the first initial six. Of course, there was a Gary Cherone album, but see how we go. Number six, I like all these albums. There's not one of these albums I don't like. Just remember that. So number six, 1982, Diver Down. Some people hate on this album because the amount of covers. It does have a few covers. The covers mostly are done well. Where Have All the Good Times Gone? King's cover, I think that's really well done. The Dancing in the Street one, not so big on that as a cover. Happy Trails is a short little, just the vocals, a short little 1 minute piece. It's okay. Big Bad Billy Sweet William Now, it's a bit of vaudeville. Quite a catchy tune. I love Secrets. I love that feel they have on that song. Really good feel through that. It's on one of my favorite Van Halen songs. Hard Rocking, Hang 'Em High is great. And The Full Bug. Yeah, but as out of the 12 tracks, you got about, I'm not going to forget Little Guitars, which is an amazing track. The song, really catchy tune. One of the best on here. And it's got little Guitars intro, which is a little intro to that. So you get a lot of that, bit of the covers, but I think it hangs together quite well. I think it's quite underrated for me, but it comes in at number six, 1982's Diver Down from the mighty Van Halen. Now, I love this album too. I didn't want to put it in this position, but I have. The second album, Van Halen 2, 1979. Everybody know, I'll go through the band, everyone will know, but David Lee Roth, Eddie Van Halen, Alex Van Halen, Michael Anthony. This is a great, great album. Love this album. Could have been higher. I love all these albums, so, you know, take it with a pinch of salt. There's not much between these for me. You're No Good. It's a good, strange to start now, an album off with a cover, but it's quite well done. Dance the Night Away, so catchy and infectious, a big hit for them. Or The Rocking, Somebody Get Me a Doctor's, great. Bottoms Up, I love. Out of Love Again, just full of great songs. Light Up the Sky is amazing. That song is just amazing. Little instrumental, Spanish Fly. DOA, one of my favorite Van Halen songs and my favorite on this album. DOA is fantastic. Women in Love's not bad, and Beautiful Girls is good. So, yep, number five for me is Van Halen 2. Okay. Number four. I went with 1984. A wonderful album. Love that cover, really great cover, really very picturesque. But 1984 starts off with the instrumental. 1984 leads into Jump, very synth driven, but a number one hit and a very catchy tune. When I first heard that, I thought this is so catchy, it's not funny. And Panama, great riff on that one. Top Jimmy's good. Drop Dead Legs is an amazing deep cut. Always love Drop Dead Legs. And the outro of The Plane of Eddie is amazing at the end of the song. But it's a very thumping type song, which is great. Hoffa teacher, great drums from Alex Van Halen, really, and Eddie Van Halen guitar. An amazing song, quite heavy song. I'll Wait is a synth-driven song, but I always liked it. I reckon it's a very cool song. That was released as a single as well. Girl Gone Bad is hard rocking, very great Van Halen song. And House of Pain, a great finish. This could have been higher again, but what do you do? Number four is 1984. Okay, number three. I went for this one, Women and Children First. Probably the most hard rocking Van Halen album, the most heavy Van Halen album, would say. Nine tracks from 1980, the third studio album. I love most of this. I love and the Cradle Will Rock. Everybody Wants Some is amazing with the great riffage and just so much full of power on that song. Fools is great. I love the intro with Eddie, how it builds up the guitar. It just plays a little bit and then the riffing comes in really good. Romeo Delight is out of this world. It's very got a lot of grunt to it and it's a very catchy tune. Little piece called Tora Tora leads into Loss of Control. Very frenetic song. Not one of my favorites, but I like it. Take Your Whiskey Home starts off with the cool guitar slowly and then rips into the riff. Really good song. Could This Be Magic? Very acoustic, little nice sort of song, isn't it? And not heavy, just a very nice acoustic tune. And what's the last song? In a Simple Rhyme. Oh, it's a good finish, a good song at the end. So a really strong album, I feel this one is. Number three, Women and Children First. Number two, I went for the first album, Van Halen, self-titled, from 1978. Great, great album. Most people's number one. Running with the Devil, great song. Eruption, amazing soloing from Eddie. Great instrumental. You Really Got Me. The Kinks cover's great. Ain't Talk About Love, probably my favourite on here. Really great song, really catchy. I'm the One, a good track. Jamie's Crying's great. Atomic Punk, Wherever You Look. Feel Your Love Tonight is probably a bit lower standard for me, but I still like it. I love Little Dreamer. I heard some people not big on that one, but I love Little Dreamer, how it starts off with the guitar part. I find it very, very catchy tune. Ice Cream Man's a cover, good song, and On Fire's a great finish, so pretty much everywhere you look on this, it's quite amazing. A really game changer in hard rock music, this one. With Eddie's virtuosity and when it came on the scene, this album was quite the game changer, yeah. So number two, Van Halen. But number one for me, which I love this album. I think it's still number one for me. Fair Warning, 1981. Very dark album, quite dark in places. Mean Street is amazing how the guitar starts and then the riff comes in. Just a great, great track. Dirty Movies is good. I like the drums. It starts off with the drums and that's quite a great song. Sinner Swing, a bit faster, frenetic, but very good. It's a cool song. Hear About It Later, slow beginning and it just takes off. That's, again, just a great side of music. If you talk on the vinyl, that side is quite amazing. And it's second half of the album, Unchained, amazing riff. One of their signature songs, I would say, Unchained, a great song. What do you got? Push Comes to Shove, love that. It's a bit different. It's got that slow bass coming in. It's got a bit of a, not a jazzy vibe, but a sort of a laid-back vibe to it. And I love his vocal on it, David Lee Roth. Really great song. Another faster song. So This Is Love, but quite in the pop catchiness side of things, you know, pretty good track. Sunday Afternoon in the Park is quite an inventive instrumental. Quite, haven't heard anything quite like it. It's only a couple of minutes. Fits in well with the album. And a good finish with One Foot Out the Door. Very short track again, but very fast and frenetic song, but a great, great album. So there you have it, guys. That's my ranking the six Van Halen albums from the David Lee Roth, the initial period. So I'll go through it again. Number one, I went for Fair Warning. Number two, the self-titled debut. Number three, Women and Children First. Number four, 1984 Van Halen. Number five, find it here. Van Halen 2. And number six is Dive It Down, quite an underrated album. So there you have it, guys. Now, there's not much between some of these for me, so some of these could change at any time. For some time, my favorite has been Fair Warning, but that's number six, Dive It Down. There you go. Okay, subscribe, like the video, comment down below, all things Van Halen. I'll see you guys again very soon for another video. Bye for now. Bye.